Shoe specialist stands at 5 feet, 8 inches tall. He weighed in at 146 pounds. He enters this fight with a record of 1 win, 1 loss, and 1 draw, and fighting out of Twins MMA and Dania Beach, Florida, he is Renee Guardsman Robert. And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, this karate-style fighter stands at 5 feet, 10 inches tall. He weighed in at 145.8 pounds. He enters this fight with a record of 1 win and 0 losses. And fighting out of Freedom Fighters in Miami, Florida, is Daniel the Last Samurai.
These guys are chomping at the bit, Blake.
And you know what else? I hate to say it. Those are some sick shorts Rivera's got on. I like those.
Yeah. Well.
Has he fought in one before? That's a pro show.
That's a pro. Yeah, I don't think so, but it's the second pair I've seen tonight that said one on them.
Indeed he do. Indeed he do. And I hate to be a rabble-rouser, start up trouble as round number one is underway. No touch of the gloves there from Renee Roberts. Renee Roberts looks a lot bigger than the Last Samurai here. Oh, looking at nice. Good job
nice
there.
Nice transition. Looking for the Ashigaray right.
Yep. No heel hooks allowed in amateur MMA due to the shin guards. Renee Robert. Big time top pressure. Good hips to stay on top.
Oh, there's a little bit of an eye poke there. But ref can't see it. Oh, got the arm behind.
Now the Last Samurai looking to do work here with that, that 7-point position. No, he's lost the arm for sure. Right into mount
right
with the Last Samurai.
Wow, this changed quickly. This was just, it seemed like it was just
the other way.
Here comes the cooking. Nice.
Yep, here
nice.
Comes that ground Freedom MMA. Deliberate, methodical, grinding, beating. Big punches there.
Oh, yeah, he's taking his time, too. He's not just going crazy.
Has the back, a couple of big punches there. Beans and rice, says my friend Kenny Florian. A rear naked choke should be forthcoming. That was clear back of the head.
Yep, that he's got to watch his weapons. That choke, can't tell if that choke's in.
I can't tell, but if it is, I don't see a hand to tap with. No, the choke is not locked.
But he is flattened out. All that has to happen here is Riveron just needs to keep punching.
He can slowly but feel it there. Now he's going to go to mount.
Oh, this
Riveron.
Is...
Not willing to sacrifice the position. I love it.
Oh, this is good. This looks like it could be the end, Blake.
Yeah, very well could be. How long will Wesley Golden let this one go on? Riveron still moving. Is he busted open? That might have been the red tape on the gloves of Riveron.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah, it could have been. I didn't see the blood, but yeah, there's
just the red tape. That's all right. Still a lot of punches landing.
This is a bad place for Robert to be.
It keeps going from bad to worse for for Renee Robert. Belly down again, flattened out. Hard to breathe in that position. Daniel Riveron slowly throwing some shots there.
Backed him out.
Yeah, not in too big of a hurry. Again, why would you be? You know you've got the control. Oh, nice job of setting that choke up there with the punches. But
30 seconds to go.
Renee Robert did a good job of hand fighting. Must have had a hand in the glove there.
Fingers in the gloves. Robert.
And that is all she wrote. He had seen enough at Wesley Golden. There is some real damage on the face of Renee Robert. He's already in the stoppage, but.
Look, I can understand. He was moving, and Renee Robert has heart.
Yeah.
But he was not going anywhere for another 30 seconds.
No. But maybe to sleep if he finally got a choke sink in on him, maybe. Now, that was a great job of ground control. And once again, no force. Just ride the hips and throw the punches.
And Wesley Golden gave Renee Robert
too much time.
Every opportunity to get out.
Yeah. Yeah, to be fair, Renee Robert was responding to commands. But, I mean, I feel like he maybe might have gave him an extra 20 seconds that weren't really justified, in my opinion. It was not. But when he said move, he moved. Renee Robert didn't move. He never really could get out of the drain, though.
And that, you know, unfortunately, and it shows you just how quick fortunes can change.
Yeah.
Here at MMA.
Yeah, Rene Robert was working to mount, fighting off a leg lock, and then I looked up again, and Riveron was on top in mount, passing the mount and doing damage. So, yep. It can happen just like that, and it happened just like that. Last Samurai takes a moment to walk around the cage. A little show of class, a little show of respect.
And that's how it should be.
Yeah, indeed.
The fight is over. It should be. That's what it should be. Again, Rene Robert always shows heart.
Yes.
But that's just, you know, that was just, he got mauled by a bear.
Yeah, that's
that
all
happens.
It was. A very, very skinny, pale bear. I mean, not skinny. He's chiseled.
Chiseled
out of wood. But he's 145 pounds. Small bear. That's like the bear
small
that
bear.
Lives under Stu Hart's porch.
More like a badger. Maybe a badger. Would you? Badger. Not a honey badger.
Do they get that big?
An American badger.
Yeah.
Maybe not that big. Wolverines are bigger.
Yeah.
I think.
All right, perfect. Let's make it official with Blake Chadwick.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 18 seconds of round number one, your winner, via TKO, out of the red corner, Daniel the Last Samurai, Riveron.
And the Ghost Squad's got a present, a white belt in jiu-jitsu, no more. Good job of riding the hips. A worthy promotion, in my opinion.
Yep. I love seeing belt promotions in the cage.
Yeah, beautiful.